ideas. So this is quite technical. So I want to sort of highlight the main parts here. The main thing is using fundamental theorem of calculus. Right, you pick a nice order of integration so that fundamental theorem comes in. And then you parameterize the boundary. Those are the two big ideas. If you've got use FTC and parameterize boundary, then you've got the whole proof. So the question is, have we proved Green's theorem? Or is there stuff missing? Right, so we've proved the following thing. So we've only got the dx part of Green's theorem, right? There's still a whole other dy part. Okay, so the so that part says this is a lot to take in. So for next Friday, it's okay. So what we need to do is we still need this second part, right? There's a second part to the proof. So let's sketch how that would work. The second part of Green's theorem. Right, so for this right-hand side now, the stuff on the right-hand side of the board. Right, we need bounds not on the y values, but on the x values. Okay, so what we're doing here is an exercise in generalizing from one proof to another proof. Mathematicians are basically, this is our job. We take something, a proof we understand, and then we play with the details until we get a new proof. So here's what we had to set up for this stuff. Now we ask ourselves, what do we have to do here? Yeah. Now we need horizontal parts. Now I need a counterclockwise orientation. Okay, so skill testing question. What order do we want to integrate this guy in? What is the nice order that'll let us use FTC? Right, we want to do this double integral, but we want to use FTC just like we did in the proof of the first part. Right, we want something that'll pair nicely with this dx. So these have to match. Then we'll use FTC there. I've literally put someone to sleep now. It happens, it's part of the job. I don't know, okay, just, never mind, that's an anecdote for later. So we use FTC here. For this guy, right, we want to parameterize this boundary. So we want f2 dy. Right, and now our bounds will run from a to b again. So we plug in our y values. We get something like this. So now we use our parameterization. Sort of our sketch of what we'd be doing in the second part. And that would be, yeah, F2, H2, F2, H1. So this is what we were used to establish the second thing. Okay. So now I want to show some of what Green's theorem can do for us, right? We've seen the proof, we've seen some of the details. Now let's see how it makes our lives a little bit better, or what we can expect to see test-wise from Green. So we'll do some sort of exercises involving simplifying things using Reef. So when we look at this, this is in principle doable by parameterizing. Yeah, so right. This could be done explicitly because you could parameterize the boundary of D and actually do the thing. Let's see what Green has to say about it. Now we're integrating over our region. So we take our vector field, we plug in the components. Now we plug in y cubed here. This is a slightly nicer integral. Now we're integrating a function over a disk. So there's a question up in the front row. Can we use polar coordinates here? Yes, that's a good suggestion. That would make things nicer for us. Okay, so we're integrating something over this sort of circle. Let's see what we get. So we switch to polar coordinates.
we want the disk of radius 2.
So
if we describe our region in polar coordinates, we get this guy. And now we have to substitute in the values of y and x. Oh, I forgot a square. Thank you. So now we've got something in R to integrate.